Before these wrestlers stepped into the ring, they signed contracts that this will be a title match. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is scheduled for...
No!
It is scheduled for one fall to a finish. Here in the corner to my right, from Auckland, New Zealand, weighing 248 pounds, Tony Garea. And his partner, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 240 pounds, Larry Zbysko. And in the corner to my left, from the Yukon, with a combined weight of 557 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, the tag team champions of the world, the Lumberjacks.
There's going to be something here. Bruno Sammartino has picked Tony Garea and Larry Zbysko to take the title for the Yukon Lumberjacks. And apparently, Luau Baru and the Lumberjacks do not consider Garea or Zbysko much of a threat. Otherwise, they'd have never granted a title match. But here we go with the action.
The following is commercial in content. Quite a bit of professional wrestling headed to the state of New Jersey in the upcoming week. On Saturday night, the 9th of December, pro wrestling appears in Flanders, New Jersey at Mount Olive High School. Scheduled to appear in Flanders, New Jersey will be the Paramount Samoan chief, Peter Maivia, who will be joined on the card by the likes of the Iron Greek Spiros Arion. And yet more wrestling action set for New Jersey in Manville, New Jersey. Professional wrestling is scheduled to appear in Manville on Thursday night, the 14th of December, and headlining the event in Manville, the Polish Power of Ivan Putski.
Big Eric in there now. Set the lockup with Zbysko. Eric applying the pressure. What's Larry thinking right now, Bruno? You have any idea?
Well, he's got about that overhead wrist lock, and Larry right now is just thinking he's not in a lot of pain because of the way he is right now, and he's just figuring a way to get out of it, and here he goes to a hammerlock.
Yes, indeed. Very nice reversal there.
You know, Vince, what I'm curious about, I really wonder, when these guys issued that challenge last week, I really wonder if they didn't do it out of anger because of the interference, and I really, really wonder if afterwards, if they really weren't sorry that they did it.
Well, they may live to regret it, no question about that, and I agree with you. I think it was a spur-of-the-moment situation, and the heat of anger, Albano issuing the challenge. The Lumberjacks didn't even know of the challenge, as we understand now. It was Albano who issued a challenge, and it took Korea Zbysko. Of course, you heard him when we interviewed him at the end of the hour last week. They were ready. I mean, they thought it was a godsend.
Well, they've been hoping for something like this for a long time, and I've talked to both of them, and I wouldn't be surprised if they even looked for an opportunity for weeks or months here to create some kind of a situation that would bring on the bout.
Quick kick out there, and both wrestlers there respecting the abilities of the other.
Well, they're not going to rush into anything, Vince. They know that this is their chance. They don't want to blow it. So they're going to be very cautious in the beginning. They're really going to try to make these guys think a little. And when they see an opening, they're going to take advantage.
All four wrestlers in the tag team title match here in great physical condition. Neither of them have been hampered by injuries as of late, Bruno.
That's true. And also, one thing about this match, they're even as far as tag team experience, because Garea and Zbysko have been together for quite some time. And so they have that great experience. They just haven't been put together to take on these two.
They have stuck together through the thick and the thin of it, no question about that. They have had several opportunities. Not too many, but several against the Lumberjacks. And as a result of disqualifications, they were unable to capitalize on winning the title. But perhaps it'll be different here, as there, Zbysko is ramped hard to the corner.
Well, you know, Vince, that's true what you just said. And that's why they're so keyed up. They told us before that they're really going to be careful. Take your time.
Oh, yes, sir. That was a mistake. And Zbysko capitalizing on that maneuver. Tony Garea coming over.
And it gets to it now.
Well, yeah, we just saw Luau Bauer now. Mr. Albauer was going to interfere in this match and perhaps be disqualified. And doing so, the Lumberjacks would have lost the match, but would not have lost the title had Mr. Albauer interfered.
That's correct. That is so right.
So, anyway, it just brings to mind that the fact that Zbyszko and Tony Garea have more than just the Lumberjacks on their mind. They have to consider Luau Bauer.
They do, and they also know, Vince, that if they don't make it this time, that they may not get another chance. That's why I think that they really thought this thing over. They're not going to let Albano throw him off the track too much. They're going to concentrate in the ring and try to ignore him completely out there.
Connecticut are really looking forward to the holiday wrestling event signed for Sunday night, the 17th of December, in New Haven at the Veterans Memorial Coliseum. Scheduled to compete on the holiday card will be an eight-man elimination tag team match, a most unusual event, a first for the Coliseum of New Haven. Scheduled as well for individual competition, Chief J. Strongbow scheduled on the card, along with the Russian Bear Ivan Koloff, all of whom are scheduled to compete on the 17th of December in New Haven, Connecticut.
Referee Dick Worley putting a warning on Luau Bauer.
Larry confused right now. He's hurt. Everything is wobbly. And he's got to get out of that corner.
Almost a double-teaming effort. The Lumberjacks are so close, and that is one of the things that they do so well, Bruno. They keep their opposition close to their corner so they can make the tag when they get in trouble.
They do it better than any team I've ever seen before, Vince.
Again, Zbyszko in no man's land over there, very close to the home corner of the Lumberjacks. They're really going to work on that left arm and shoulder. Luau Bauer gets it a cheap shot.
Cheap shot is right. I like to see Larry try to tag to Garea, because if he does, they're going to do so much damage to that arm. And he made the tag of it.
Garea comes over. No, referee Dick Welly was a strike, and he said no. Albano really going to work on Zbyszko. Now, that would certainly be cause, Bruno, for disqualification. Not in itself would be cause for disqualification. Give credit to Dick Worley. He knows what this match means to Garea and Zbyszko. And he's going to let him go just as long as he can keep some type of order in this match.
He's going to give him all four, every opportunity in the world to have a decisive decision here one way or the other. He's doing his best not to cause a disqualification or anything like that. But again, he can only go so far, and I hope that it doesn't really happen.
Again, Zbyszko, who has been in quite a bit of trouble, a roundhouse right that found its mark. However, Pierre quickly counters. Zbyszko trying to kick anything.
Tremendous slam, but if he could have only gone towards his corner to get to Garea. He's just hurt right now. He's unable to really move.
Larry cannot tag Tony Garea. That's the one thing that he wants to do more than anything else right now.
Oh, boy.
Over and right into Eric waiting. And there, you see the tag. So now a fresh Lumberjack steps through. Zbyszko, double team. Tony Garea coming over. He's hot enough, but that's not really helping your partner out.
Huh? See, he's trying to help him out. He's actually, that time, did him a little more arm because the referee busy taking him out of the ring. And these two, oh, almost.
Oh, yes, sir. Close. Down at two. Zbyszko again reaching for the tag and just too far away. Larry has been taking tremendous amounts of punishment here. Kick to the chest. Unfortunately, Zbyszko back over to the Lumberjack corner. All right, we make it. Let's go, Ray. Tony Garea, forearm back, a house of fire. The Lumberjack won it all. Come on.
really thought Dewey had everything under control. I really thought he was going to beat the Lumberjack. But boy, he got caught with that knee right in by the solar plexus, and that really knocked Gurria down.
And now it's Gurria. Big double team in the Lumberjack corner. Tony coming over. Now that's the Visco on the far side. They can't get together. All four wrestlers in the ring now. A clash together. No. Gurria and Visco taking over against the Lumberjack. Again, all four wrestlers in the ring.
I like what I'm seeing. I like what I see.
Including Lou Albano, who earlier, look at this,